Breaking news overnight. The son of a sheriff's deputy is under arrest, accused of starting those fires at three historically black churches in Louisiana.
Law enforcement sources say he's this man, 21-year-old Holden Matthews.
Authorities are still working to determine a motive.
Now, in order to try and decipher what his motivation for burning down three historic, predominantly black churches was, we're going to turn to our friends at Jeopardy.
Jeopardy.
I'll go with excuses for white supremacists for 200, please. Three black churches were burned down by a white dude. What was the motivation? What is video games? Oh, sorry, nope, wrong answer.
What is a lone wolf?
Not quite, sorry again. What is black metal music? Correct, your answer? The Daily Double. Oh yes, now joining the list of excuses for white supremacists is black metal music.
On his Facebook page, police found that Matthews is a fan of black metal.
Called into a fire official investigating the cause of these fires, this crucial piece of information was run as a headline, rather than potentially some of the other likely reasons, which is that he had engaged on social media, albeit heavy metal pages, that were awash in white supremacy. But neither this nor the fact that he targeted black churches was enough to determine a motive. As Governor Edwards said, he didn't know what Matthews' alleged motive was. Cannot be justified or rationalized. It was an evil act. I mean, I agree with you, Governor, it was an evil act, and it's not like this country has a long and painful history of white supremacists targeting black churches fueled by racist motives or anything, right? But no, I guess not. Not in today's climate. A climate where Hitler apologist Candace Owens is offered a seat at a congressional hearing to claim white supremacy is a myth, and that the threat of white supremacists is actually, well, kind of made up. Because it's not like almost every single extremist attack committed in the US in 2018 was by white supremacists, right? Oh, yeah, they were. But as I tweeted out after this headline, this is actually par for the course whenever something like this happens. Media outlets will run headlines about how the perpetrator was bright in science class or mowed the neighbor's lawn. That might be excusable, except that whenever a black man is shot and killed by police, the first thing we hear about is usually that he had a joint in his third drawer, oh, that the cop didn't know about. Or that he maybe had a dispute with his partner that also the police didn't know about before shooting him. Or he was no angel. Meanwhile, Holden here, and countless others like him, are almost always humanized. And the thing is, that only serves to downplay the severity of their motivation, a motivation that has sparked a rise in hate crimes across the country. And here's the thing, man, you can dislike me all you want. You can say I'm a virtue signaler, which I still don't really know what that is, or a hate spewer or whatever. But if all I'm doing is telling you statistics that the FBI have published in regards to hate crimes, then doesn't that actually mean there's a lot of hate out there? If I'm just reporting such stats, and I'm sorry to tell you peeps, but not reporting on them doesn't make it go away. Excusing white supremacy doesn't resolve it. Hell, a lot of people in this country have been doing that for years, and look where that's got us. I mean, here I was thinking that you guys were the party of facts, not feelings. Well, the fact is, it's making excuses like this that is the problem. But I want to know what you think. You can come over to my Instagram at Francis M. Maxwell. If you want to support TYT right here, it's only $5 a month. You can go to tyt.com/join. Did you know that TYT Network is now available on YouTube's new streaming platform, YouTube TV? Get access to full TYT episodes and exclusive shows by signing up for YouTube TV today. All new subscribers get a 7-day free trial, so head over to youtube.tv and search for the TYT Network channel.